The medical watch, a hands-off approach to saving a life.
A new automated device could help first responders in the field. WGN's medical reporter Dina Baer has more.
We're talking about CPR. First responders typically take turns administering chest compressions because it can be so taxing. Now there's some extra pumping power on board the ambulance.
It's the busiest station in northwest suburban Mount Prospect. Crews here respond to about 18 calls a day, mostly medical needs. When it's a cardiac arrest, paramedics start with manual CPR. Fatigue is a factor.
Everybody gets fatigued. You can only go for so long. And the protocols before was a constant rotation of personnel. After, you know, a minute or two, you bring somebody else in. When you first start out, you're providing those compressions, and you don't realize that as time goes on, you know, 30, 40, a minute, you start to slow down, or maybe your depth isn't the same, or you're not, you know, consistent.
But now, within a minute or so, another steady and powerful force takes over.
Device is going to be clicked on one side, it gets clicked on the other.
The device is an automatic compression device used for CPR. It takes the place of a person doing chest compressions.
We now have some free hands. We can go ahead and pull out our stuff to start our medications.
With the automated device in place, the paramedics are freed up and focused on the patient's other needs. Mount Prospect Fire Department EMS coordinator Susie Bagdad and her team showed us the technology in action.
The idea of the compression is to circulate the blood, because the heart isn't pumping. So you are now pumping the heart through the compression. So the rate and the depth is very important, and this device provides that constant, same rate, same depth throughout the process.
The department purchased four of the automated CPR devices with the help of a grant. Each ambulance in circulation has one on board. The device stays on the patient, pumping all the way to the hospital.
Early CPR is a key factor of being able to save somebody, and you know, the device is just some part of that. Whether it was the device or somebody manually doing compressions, you know, the outcome would most likely be the same.
Save rates among EMS services across the northwest suburbs are about 43% when it comes to cardiac arrest. That's well above the national average. And as always, bystanders who jump into action to perform CPR can save a life. Back to you.